Good evening, everyone. Please welcome Bo Sia.
To whom it may concern, keep going. From the rallies to the research, from the pulpits to the programs, from the mayors to the miners, keep going. Through hate years terrorizing elders, through hate laws targeting powerless, through hate ways trolling many into silence, this too shall pass. Keep going, cause our ancestors taught us way more than how to wash rice and the etiquette of respect. They showed us the solidarity of justice bigger than origin story. They kept going when there were no allies to be found, when they were the first anyone had ever seen, when none of us were around to support them. If you benefited from their sacrifice, keep going. Even when grifters try to sell you that nothing matters, keep going towards mattering. Even when uncles check out defeated, keep going to inspire them back to possible. Even when you feel like you are the only one, know that you were never alone. Know that you have always belonged to the of freedom, to the way of love, to the world of folks striving for more than concessions of an owner's will. So keep going until grandma walks home safe always, until books contain the history we gave America, until box office an afterthought of our value, until independence for the independent, until elections become true reflections. Learn from Naomi and refuse to run from within for the sake of others' comfort, until identity not a white construct, until communities protected by authorities, until ancestry present in togethering tomorrow. Learn from Patsy and work less for glamour and more for gain, until gender not under patriarchy's purview, until justice isn't skin deep, until borders less important than people. Learn from Bruce and go from kicking down doors to building doorways. Until the inclusion is not an exclusion of class. Until our humanity blooms from symbols into culture. Until we stop waiting for others' permission to be seen. Why wait for those who would rather we throw up our hands and settle for scraps again? Nah, keep going until our love becomes the foundation for forever. Until the American dream is translated for each of us. Until we transform from being invisible to them into undeniable for all. Thank you.
Welcome, Shaker Norasimhan.
Welcome to a historic evening. What a start Bo Sia gave us. You know, it felt like our Amanda Gorman moment, didn't it? I hope we are all inspired to keep going. Frankly, I'm just pinching myself that we are here in the iconic Kennedy Center with the Vice President of the United States. By the way, I assume you all knew that she's an Asian American woman, right? Okay. And for into an incredible cast of next generation leaders and celebrities. You know what? It feels like we have arrived. So today, we will bring fashion, culture, and awareness together to create a new political brand that reflects our values. We are saying as one, our vote, our voice, our power. Now, do you feel inspired enough to do that with me? Our vote, our voice, and our power. We actually want it to be cool to be Asian American, Native Hawaiian, and a Pacific Islander. And we actually want it to be cool to, for them and us to go to vote. The movement to build AAPI power began well over a century ago, but it was 2015 when we started this journey in earnest, which was to mobilize the votes of our 23 million strong and fast-growing community. We have made significant progress, but on this May 20th, which is the first anniversary of the signing of the COVID hate crimes bill by President Biden, we know yes, bipartisan and sponsored by Representative Grace Meng and Senator Mazie Hirono, two of our champions. But what we know a year later is there is much unfinished business. And the battles ahead will be hard. But Bo said it so well. Our ancestors did not shy away from battles. So how can we? Our path forward is to organize, motivate, then lead and win. And we must, because we have to preserve and enhance our democracy for our children and theirs. Let's just keep reminding ourselves, this is our America, and we must cherish that and the power of our vote. So, I'm not going to stop you from the rest of the program very long, but I want to tell you that the reason we have these amazing people here today is because we brought somebody from the next generation to come and lead this organization. And with him, Brad Jenkins, President and CEO of the AAPI Victory Action Fund. Is Jeannie May, who's an Emmy Award-winning host and producer, and they're gonna light the stage on fire. Thank you for being here.
American fellow people out there, how you doing tonight? Brad and I, man, we're taking in this moment because this is really
cool,
happening.
Y'all. We're here.
Yes, everybody.
They let us in the building.
Welcome, everybody.
In the building, and this audience. I mean, here's the thing: the lights are dim, but you can still see how beautiful.
Yes.
And how powerful this room is. Give yourselves a round of applause. I know so many people came from all over the country to be here. Thank you so much. So my name is Brad Jenkins, and yeah, I know, it's the worst Asian name of all time. It's a horrible Asian name. I think my parents named me Brad Jenkins for this moment. They knew one day I would be here in front of the most powerful Asians in America with the name Brad Jenkins. It's unfortunate, Jeannie. But here's the thing. Not only am I excited to be here because you're here, Jeannie Mai Jenkins. We have a round of applause for Jeannie. She is an Emmy Award-winning host. She's an icon. And she's a Vietnamese baddie.
Hey, thank you, Brad, thank you. And you did say I'm a Jenkins suit, so technically, I mean that we're fam, you know that, right?
That's true. We're fam, so we gotta give a shout out to Jeezy Jenkins in the house. the legend. I mean, we're cousins, right, Jesus?
Thank you for supporting, hubby. Oh, man, this is such an awesome night. I'm really, really elated to be here and to see all these faces that have come together for the first ever inaugural event of this kind. This month is all about celebrating the AAPI history that we have here today. It's all about, I mean, it doesn't just mean celebrating the heritage, but the roots, you know, the showing the beautiful diversity of what it means to really just be Asian American, yeah. You know?
It's true. And again, we come from everywhere, right? We are not a monolith. We come from so many different cultures, so many different languages. And the beauty of that diversity for us, at least for me, is this incredible lineup that we have for y'all. I mean, we've got everyone.
Yeah. And whether you're East Asian, Southeast Asian, Native Hawaiian, whether yes. your family has been here since the 1700s when the first Filipinos settled in New Orleans.
That's right. Or you just immigrated to the United States, right? That is that arc. And we are the fastest growing community in the country, 23 million strong.
That's right.
So tonight, everybody, we will celebrate our collective and individual voices. Here at the Kennedy Center, we will amplify our power in the face of violence and discrimination.
And most importantly, we will celebrate our votes.
Yes.
We stand at the precipice of one of the most important elections of our lifetime. Not just because our community's safety is at risk, not just because our community's economic security is at risk, but democracy itself is at risk. And we have to galvanize every single one of our Asian American brothers and sisters to vote.
Absolutely.
We gotta do it.
1 year ago today, Brad, President Biden signed the COVID-19 Hate Crimes Act into law, thanks to leaders like Congressman Meng and Senator Hirono. And Brad, can you believe that even though we have been a part of building the American culture for hundreds of years, we today still don't have a space, y'all, that recognizes the contributions we have made to building this country to what it is today. And because of the voices of the people and the pressure from everybody in this room, the Senate and the House passed a bill yesterday, and we are going to have our first ever Asian American museum.
That's right.
Change.
That's right. And tonight, as we mentioned before, is a night where we're bringing everyone together. We're going to honor and celebrate the best and brightest young Asian American leaders from politics, from culture. And honestly, we're going to party.
Yeah.
After this, we're going upstairs and we're going to honor and celebrate them. It's an incredible moment. The other thing too, because I am, again, a very confused looking Asian.
Come on.
But I am African American and I'm Asian American.
Hey!
And I want to give a shout out. I have to give a shout out to our other communities of color
yes.
in the room that we are building alliances
yes.
on the ground with. You gotta give it up. The NAACP is in the house.
Where you at? NAACP, where you at?
The Latino Victory Fund is in the house. This alone.
Yes, and tonight for the first time you're ever about to see a bunch of talented Asian faces celebrating our month here in DC. Why? Because we have a Black and Asian female vice president!
Let's go!
Next generation leaders that we will be honoring after the program. State Senator Sonia Chang Diaz from Massachusetts. Yes. Delegate Kelly Tran from Virginia. State Senator Joe Wynn from Washington. Yes.
Tonight we are also awarding all of these incredible performers. Please give a huge round of applause to both. CNU yes. is incredible. And we have a very special treat, MC Jin. MC Jin is in the house, the first Asian American signed to a major record label deal. He's gonna bless us as well.
Yes, and we also have speeches from the most powerful AAPI voices in America. Pulitzer Prize winning Jose Antonio Vargas is in the house.
Yes.
Award-winning author and essayist Min Jin Lee.
Yes.
And of course, did we mention, we got the boss herself, Vice President of the United States, Kamala Harris. Here in the community, a voice, an actor, producer, and activist who has been such a strength in our community to standing up to hate, violence, and discrimination, the one and only Daniel Day Kim.
Celebrate the one-year anniversary of the signing of the COVID-19 Hate Crimes Bill. It's a seminal piece of legislation made possible by many of the people who you'll soon see on stage and the monumental push by our community. Tonight's event, brought to you by the AAPI Victory Power Fund, is the first ever of its kind celebrating Asian American, Native Hawaiian, and Pacific Islanders, and that is nothing short of remarkable. Now, when I think about the tragic events of the past few years, one of the few silver linings has been the growing number of Americans from all walks of life who have found their voice and become advocates for our community as well as a society free from hate. That's why Vice President Kamala Harris' story and her fight resonates with so many of us. Vice President Harris has a long career fighting for our community as well as black and brown communities, and she has led with honesty, courage, and passion. As Vice President, she has worked in partnership with President Joe Biden to get America vaccinated, rebuild our economy, reduce child poverty, and pass an infrastructure law that will lift up communities that have been left behind. She's led the administration's efforts in rallying broad coalitions to protect the freedom to vote, expand workers' right to organize and collectively bargain, appoint a more representative judiciary, and stand up for women's rights. Rights that support women in our workforce, address the maternal health crisis, as well as her work defending reproductive rights. The Vice President has also played a key role in engaging world leaders to strengthen our nation's alliances and partnerships. In everything she does, she remains focused on the people of our nation and our collective future. But most importantly, she never forgot where she and Tammy Duckworth to make sure issues affecting RAAMHPI don't go unheard or unseen. It means the world to not just have allies, but to have elected officials who understand that the grief our community has felt is real. Our Vice President is one of those people. A year ago, in an address to the AA and NHPI community, Vice President Harris stated, "And I believe we have an opportunity now to turn that pain into action. To turn that pain, that righteous anger, because of the injustice of it, we have an opportunity to turn that into power. That's why we're here today. to turn that pain and that outrage into power. We need to show that our community does not cower against these violent acts, including just a week ago where a gunman shot three Korean women in a hair salon in Dallas, that we are willing to stand strong together, turn our action into historic momentum, and vote. This November, we must vote. It's why I am proud to be here today to introduce our next guest. Ladies and gentlemen, Vice President Kamala Harris.
Chairman Shekar, where are you? Thank you for all that you do. Where is he? He's backstage, of course, working. That was a beautiful tribute, our dear friend Norm Mineta. And Norm's story is a reminder of why we must stay in the fight. No matter how many reasons we are given to quit, Norm Mineta, who I knew and considered a mentor for my entire elected career. He truly helped inspire a generation, I think generations of leaders to enter public service, including me. And it was good to be at the Rose Garden with his family, honoring his legacy and his life. And it is, of course, always good to be with so many friends, including Congressman Andy Kim, Mayor Michelle Wu, and Mayor Ashab Perival. Thank you all for your leadership. And the other electeds who may be in the room, you know I love you. I'm sorry if I don't know you're here. And we were all together just a few days in the Rose Garden. And for those who weren't there, when I was standing at the podium, and I was there with the president, of course, and so many others, and I looked out, it was the biggest crowd that we've had at the Rose Garden. And it was extraordinary to see the leadership of our nation who were in attendance from every walk, from every field, there representing the best of who we are as a nation. And it was such a great tribute to the great people of our nation. When we think about the leaders that were there, the leaders we remember, and all of those who paved a path for so many of us to be where we are today. And this month and every month, of course, with pride, we celebrate the contributions of those great leaders, Asian Americans, Native Hawaiians, Pacific Islanders across our nation. And within the celebration, of course, this year, and sadly last year and before, it is impossible to celebrate and ignore that we celebrate at a time, I'm saying at this moment in time, where I do believe there's, and we are witnessing, an epidemic of hate in our country. And we only need to look at the events of the last 2 weeks in Buffalo and Laguna Woods and Dallas. You know, we have always known, and we believe in speaking truth as leaders, we have always known that racism is real in America, that xenophobia is real in America, that sexism is real in America. And today we are witnessing again and again the terrible human cost of this hate. We are seeing this hate manifest itself in violent acts. And I think we all are clear about the threat There are people who believe that America is meant only for some and not for all, who scapegoat and attack people because of their race, because of their ethnicity, because of their gender. People who see diversity and inclusion as a weakness, not as the strength we all know it to be. So yes, this moment does require reflection in addition to action. It does require reflection that comes with the question, who are we as a nation and what do we stand for? I look at America today, and yes, as I've said, I see an epidemic of hate that seems to be growing, but I also see a country that still embodies its most profound belief, which is that we are all in this together as one nation, undivided, and that this moment then calls on us to come together as a community and as a country. A moment to talk about how we live to the greatest and best of our ideals. And most importantly, it is a moment for action. We must take action to end an epidemic of any sort, including an epidemic of hate. We must mobilize in support of the notion that harm against any one of us is a harm against all of us. And we must... And we must organize against those who seek to incite violence. I believe this is a collective fight, and that each of us here has an important role to play. Daniel talked about the coalition. He and I were talking about that backstage. We have, each of us, an important role to play in bringing together the various groups of people who all we understand that we have so much more in common than what separates us. We have the work in front of us that we are doing just this very evening to support the AAPI Victory Fund, knowing that it mobilizes and turns out voters, and that that work could not be more important in this moment. And just think about it. We have a track record of knowing it makes a huge difference. 2 years ago, the work of this group and these leaders helped send President Joe Biden and me to the White House. Yeah. And turn the Senate blue. Yes. And you know, we all know, because many of us have been doing this for a long time, when we talk about turning out the vote, we know that we are prepared to do what is necessary to connect with folks through whatever medium. It may be a knock on a door, it may be a text, it may be a phone call, an email. And we know, those of us who have been doing it for a long time, some people will turn to us and say, well, why should I vote? And we have things to point to. Think about it. Since the time of the 2020 election, our administration together, all of us working together, we've taken action to protect our AA and NHPI communities. Back when I was in the Senate, it's been mentioned before, Senator Hirono, Senator Duckworth, and I introduced a resolution in the Senate condemning the rise in anti-Asian sentiment across our country, the hate that was rising. And we gathered tonight then on the first anniversary of the day that President Biden signed into law the bipartisan COVID-19 Hate Crimes Act. That law provides resources and training to state and local law enforcement to accurately identify and report hate crimes, because we work on the detail, all of us together. We know that we need to address those fissures and failures in the system that might cause a lack of accountability for these horrendous acts. We know that we need to address, and this is what we did with that law, language and cultural barriers that make it different for our communities to report these crimes. And our administration has taken steps to address not only that which holds us back, but also that which moves us forward. So we have created 8.5 almost million jobs since taking office 15 months ago, a record-setting pace in job creation. Unemployment is down to 3.6%. We passed an historic infrastructure law that is already delivering results for the American people. Earlier today, I have to tell you, one of the things I'm just so completely excited about, it is my inner nerd. I'm so excited about electric school buses. And part of what we did with the bipartisan infrastructure law is we're putting billions of dollars into this thing. You know, 25 million of our children every day go to school on those buses. And they're breathing these exhaust systems, right? And it's having a direct impact on their health and therefore their ability to learn. But these are the kinds of things we've been doing, all of us. When we get out the vote, when we remind people of what is at stake, and then when we deliver, including what we will continue to do, of course, in terms of lowering costs for working families. And I should note, we have appointed more Asian Americans at every level in our government, including to the federal judiciary, and we know what that means. And because of the work of the Victory Fund and the support and the hard work in 2020, our country is therefore getting back on track. And this year, then, we need our voters to once again be the margin of victory. Asian voters were the margin of victory in 2020. So as the midterm elections draw near, we know that so much is at stake. The progress we have already made, the progress we must make on voting rights, workers' rights, women's rights, the work we must do to bring down costs, to create good-paying jobs, union jobs, the work we must do to ensure that everyone has an opportunity to succeed no matter where their grandmother was born. It is not hyperbole to say what we do between now and November will determine the future our nation. Truly. So we need to make sure that AA and NHPI voices are heard at the ballot boxes around our country, just as we need to make sure that those voices are represented in all levels of government. Asian Americans must be in the rooms where the decisions are being made. Because when policies reflect our experiences, our collective experiences, our perspectives, I am certain of one thing. Our country is stronger. And our country is more just. So there are no questions, of course. There is not a question that there are obstacles on our road to progress, but the strength of our country has always been that despite the challenges, we ultimately fight our way toward a more perfect union. The President and I remain focused, as do we all, on the path forward toward a better future for all people. A future free from the dark scourge of hate, a future where every child can reach their potential, where every community is safe and healthy, and yes, where every woman gets to make decisions about her own body. A future where when When someone has a good idea or a dream, they will have access to capital to start and grow a business, a future where workers are treated with dignity, with an appreciation for the value of their skill and their work, and where, again, every person can succeed and thrive. I believe, as I know we all do, that we can build that future together. So let us continue with our work, having confidence that what we are doing is making a difference. But here's the deal. I believe there is nothing that we have achieved in this nation that has been about progress. It did not come with hard work and, yes, struggle, sometimes a good fight. We're up for it. So let's continue to do this good work together. Thank you all, and take care.